Hello, this is Erica Blessing, and I'm cutting a video on how to get your messages out big in a bigger way because lately it seems like a lot of light workers and a lot of people that I publish are holding back their lightness and they're holding back from sharing themselves with the media. And what I get is there is a place when we start to create, when we choose to be seen in the media, when we choose to reach out to more people with our messages. And there's kind of a requirement that we understand. Not everyone's going to understand our message and not let that stop us, you know? Because sometimes we're on the cutting edge and we're in a different reality. And so we're showing this new reality, and it's a lot like the Jonathan Livingston Seagull story. Hey, I can fly! They're like scrappling for food on the ground. They're like, "Hey, I can fly!" And they're like, "Oh my God, you know, who is that person flying? You know, leave us, leave us." And so you might perceive that seems like a coldness from the media, but I was the media for a really long time. And technically, I'm still the media because I have two podcasts now. I have two shows that I produce, not just one. So, when you look at the messages and how you can reach people, one of the tools you can use is dramatizing and storytelling with bigger drama, you know? And people get all caught up in, I need to be completely, you know, truthful. And I do believe in being truthful. And also, how can this be positioned so that your worst are worse than worse, and your best are better than best, and your worst are worse, and your best are best, and your worst are worse, and your best are best, and you go on through intensity, and then you go through some victory, and you go through some intensity. If you look at something like Entrepreneur on Fire, a very successful podcast, every single day he makes the guest say, "My worst, worst, worst moment when nothing was working." Like for me, when my first bestseller campaign, the book landed 6,000. It was a brilliant book. It was called Manifest Change. It was so good. And I did my first bestseller campaign. And I've been shown, you know, do a bestseller campaign. The book got to 6,000 on the bestseller charts. It's like, oh my goodness, all this work and it got to 6,000. However, the very next book was The Energy of Happiness. I also have it in front of me. That got to number one. And then I never looked back. Well, I looked back a lot. But that one never, I shifted the energy completely. But I had to do one that was like an epic fail. And so any place that you're willing to tell your story with a little bit of extra drama, a little bit of extra intensity, a little bit of extra energy, that's going to be the way that you tell your story when you're looking at media, because they have a need to tell stories that pull people in order for media to exist. So you have to look at what can I create that's kind of strategic for whatever media person. And when I was a news reporter, I'd wake up in the mornings when I worked for the Sacramento Bee, which is a great paper, and I would scan everything and look for the hottest stories. And then I would sit on the phone with my editor, her name's Loretta. She finally retired, she was there for a million years. And I'd say, "Loretta, these are my stories." And she cherry-picked the ones. And I had to actually frame how I said them to her to get the assignment that I wanted, because otherwise I might cover garbage. You know, there was this big issue of garbage up there at one point. And if I didn't frame my other stories that I wanted to write about, like how did Grass Valley get their dropout rate so low? I wanted to write about that. If I didn't frame it really, really with a lot of like extra drama, then I'd end up covering the garbage story again. So you have to look at how can I frame my stories in a way that's strategic to the media. And that's kind of like what showed up for me the last few days, and I'm eager to bring that work to the light. So get with me if you have any questions about that or how you might be able to take your story and get it to run bigger and shine brighter. Thanks so much for listening.